Some people call this the most important seat in the house, and there are many words describing what the fixture is used for. So, it's time to talk toilet.
What's another word for some of the bodily functions in a bathroom?
Bowel movement?
It's a download.
For years, toilet talk focused mainly on water, clean water, and the water supply.
What's another word for some of the functions in a bathroom?
Number one and number two.
Well, here's the thing. For all the bathroom humor, in industrialized countries, developed countries like the United States, we take bathrooms for granted. It's because clean water, sanitation, sewage facilities are in good supply. But in developing countries like India, sanitation, clean water, sewage facilities are in short supply, and that is a real health problem.
We have about 2.5 billion people, that's about 38% of the world's population, that do not have access to safe and effective sanitation. So something that we just take for granted is not available to about 38% of the world.
So in this garage at RTI International in Research Triangle Park, toilet talk means building a better toilet for places with no sanitation.
It's not just the part that you interact with when you go to the bathroom. It's a self-contained waste treatment system. So what we're trying to do is we're trying to treat all of the waste on site, liquid and solid, in a single location so that whatever we discharge is safe and effective for use or reuse. So what we're doing is we're taking the solid waste, we're converting that into a burnable fuel, and from that we get enough energy to be able to thermally then dry the incoming solid waste, but then we create enough electricity to convert the salts that naturally exist in urine into chlorine and other disinfectants.
And here's how. And that's not the real stuff you're watching, it's test material. The reimagined toilet centers on a biological and chemical fact about the tinkle and doo-doo that we produce.
Human waste that's being discharged has some value.
Just like in the natural world, the dirty stuff can be converted to clean stuff. One organism's waste is another's nutrient.
As much as possible, we want to be able to recycle and reuse the products that we produce on site. So you cannot rely on regular municipal supplies from electricity or water or sewage treatment.
Again, that's just test material. But to process material, real or imagined, the toilet uses about 1.5 liters of water. Even modern low-flow toilets use about 6 liters. And here's how it works.
Everything comes in through the conventional S-trap, and think of these as just rubber bands. Water goes through the rubber bands, moves forward, the feces doesn't stick to that. Everything gets mixed in through here and extruded out this end right here.
Okay, so it, through here.
It gets extruded out this tube. So here we're just preparing the fuel. If we just put the fuel directly into the tumble dryer, it would start to stick together. So we're searing a little bit before it goes into the dryer, slowly turning it over and over and over again while hot air passes over it. And just think of this, it's like a slow laundry dryer. It's a tumble dryer that slowly turns the fuel over and over until it's sufficiently dry to be able to go into the combustor. So this is what the typical fuel looks
that's
like.
The fuel.
That's it. And that's actual feces.
The pellets of solid waste don't smell, and it's the burning of the waste that fuels everything.
Part of that thermal energy comes back into this dryer, and that's what's used to dry the next batch.
Right.
And the other part of it is converted into electrical energy, and that gets stored in a battery.
The stored electricity is used to convert the liquid waste to salts and chlorine, which disinfects the liquid waste and converts it to non-potable water. That is used in the system.
We keep numbers on every bit of material that goes into that system. We know weights and measurements on.
And the numbers show there is no waste in this safe, self-cleaning, and self-contained sanitation machine.
Their kids can actually die from diarrhea, and it happens every day. So, yeah, I like to say clean water is sexy, right? People don't have a problem seeing that on the screen. A little child drinking some clean water hits home. A kid defecating in the open, people don't want to see that, even though that's the biggest issue that's facing the developing world right now.
The system is designed to serve a small village, about a dozen families. A prototype is being tested in India, but it's not just the technical aspects of the reimagined toilet that are being evaluated.
One of the things we're evaluating is, are you comfortable using the same toilet, and are there things that we could make the one seat option be acceptable for a shared community? Does the concept of recycling water, the urine that we clean and recycle, is that culturally acceptable? Because that's a key part of our system in terms of saving water and making the processes work. We're also evaluating and getting their feedback on the burning of human waste. And are you comfortable to see that happen on site, underneath where you go to the bathroom? And what we're finding is people are extremely excited about it and they're quite comfortable with it.
Yeah, I like to say clean water is sexy, right? People don't have a problem seeing that on the screen. A little child drinking some clean water hits home. A kid defecating in the open, people don't want to see that, even though that's the biggest issue that's facing the developing world right now.